Hey everyone, how's it going? My name is Richard. Welcome back to the Trader Lion channel. Now today in this video, we're gonna be talking about what ultimately matters when it comes to trading in determining whether your system is profitable or not. And you might think the key is stock selection, position management, all of that, and that does play a part, but what ultimately matters is your results at the end of the day. And those results are basically summarized in three different statistics: the summary statistics, your average gain, your average loss, and your batting average. Now describing each of these three statistics, your batting average is the percentage of trades that ultimately end up with profits. Your average gain is of those winning trades, what is your average gain? Basically sum up all your different profits and divide by the number of gains. And the average loss is very similar. Basically you sum up all the losses you've taken, divide by the total number of losses, and that gets you this statistic. So these three factors, your average gain, average loss, batting average, basically determine at the end of the day whether your system is profitable or not. And it doesn't matter if you're a day trader, swing trader, position trader, investor, at the end of the day, these results are what matters. And on this page right here, and I'll have the link to this template down below if you want to download it, you basically have a bunch of average gain, average loss pairs, and then you can see the results after 10 trades using different batting averages. So say in 10 trades, 50 of them are gains, 50 of them are losses, and your average gain was 8%, your average loss was 4%, you can see that at the end of the day, that position that you compounded out should have gained 19.8%. And we can even do 25 trades to switch things up, and you can see how different batting averages, along with different average gain, average loss pairs, change your results. So really the first thing you wanna do is analyze your own trades and basically determine what is your current average gain, average loss, and what is your current batting average. And the way to do that, we've got a sheet over here. And basically what you want to do is download a statement from your broker, analyze an Excel sheet, something like this, where you've got all the gains in one column, all the losses in one column, and then the returns as well. And very simply, your average gain is the average of these four trades, and you've got your average loss as well is the average of these six losses. So you've got a gain to loss ratio of 2.33, that's quite good. And you've got a batting average of 40%. And you might be thinking to yourself that 40% is quite low, but if you're able to establish your edge in terms of the ratio between the gain to the loss, that means that you build in a lot of failure. So if in a normal market, your average gain is 10.5, your average loss is 4.5, but your batting average is 40%, that's decent. That means when you've got a year like 2020 and your batting average is much higher because things are really taking off and working, that means you can really compound your money, and you've also built in a lot of failures. So even if your batting average dips to 35% in a bad market, you will still end up being pretty much net even because you built in failure with regards to your average gain to average loss. So this is very simply how you would set up to calculate your average gain, average loss, and your batting average. Now, this is a very simplified version because obviously this team trade could have been much more of your portfolio than a CLF or an apps trade. So this is very simple, but obviously this is just kind of in general the system you want to do and how you calculate it in Excel. Now going back to this sheet right here, this is kind of the meat of this video. I want to show how different average gain to average loss pairs along with different batting averages change expectations and your expected return after a set number of trades. So let's go back to 10 trades and start with just an average gain to average loss ratio of 1. So you make 10% on average on gains, but you also lose on average 10% on losses. So this is not what you want to do because you can see that unless you have a 50% or higher batting average, you're most likely not making any money regardless of your average gain or average loss. So even if you make 100%, if you give it all back, you're not going to make anything on that position. So you want to avoid this because this is not building in failure. In good environments, you might have a batting average of over 50%, but when things get choppy, especially like in 2021, you're going to have more like a 40-35% batting average. And you can see right here that your expected return after 10 trades is negative, and you want to avoid that at all costs. So really what you want to do is build in failure by managing your risk and establishing your edge in terms of the risk-reward relationship, your average gain, average loss. So here We've got a average gain to average loss ratio of 2 to 1. So whatever your average gain to average loss is, you have to calculate that for yourself. You can see that, for instance, if you have an average gain of 10% on winners, but average loss of 5% on losers, you can see that you only need about a 35-40% return to be profitable. And in good markets, like when you're swinging 50-55%, you're really compounding your money out in just 10 trades. And if we do about 25 trades, you can see that the returns really start to add up. And you might be wondering, what are these blue columns that have been highlighted here? Well, basically, for any given batting average, this is the optimal risk reward for that particular batting average. So for 40%, the average, the optimal risk reward is 20% on gainers and 10% on losers. Now, obviously, we've talked about before in previous videos and in the courses and Leadership Blueprints that you don't want to give back more than 8% on any given trade on average. And ideally, it's much, much less than that. And that's because at that point, it's much, much harder to make back that money, and you're better off cutting your loss and just moving on to another thing that could potentially work. So I don't really recommend using any of the bottom average gain, average loss ratios. And if you do go ahead and calculate your summary statistics and figure out that your average gain is, for instance, 40%, that's fantastic. You're finding some big, big winners. But at the same time, you can see that your average loss, for instance, is 20%. You might want to rethink your strategy and try to limit those losses a little bit more. And the reason that I say that is because if you look at this table and see what happens when you've got this type of relationship and your batting average really starts to slip at about 35-30%, your risk of ruin is extremely high. And if you are able to cut your losses a little bit more, you can see that even at 35%, you're not really losing most of your capital. And at the end of the day, preserving your capital is the most important thing. So definitely consider that. And I also want to show what happens when you get a really good gain and loss ratio of, for instance, 3. So each of these have an average gain and then an average loss. Basically, these pairs are set up so the gain and loss ratio is 3. So at this point, even if you're at 30-35%, for the majority of these, you're doing quite well and you're able to compound out your gains. And in a good market, if you're able to get your batting average up to 40-50%, you're really compounding those gains and are able to basically double this position in just 25 trades. So really, I would recommend shooting for a gain loss ratio of at least 2 to 1 if you're a kind of swing trader type. But if you're a position trader, try to get to 3, even 4 to 1, because really that's building in a lot of failure. So even when the markets turn and your system isn't working as well as it can be in a great bull market like in 2020, you're still not risking ruin because you're building in a lot of failure. And your edge is basically in your risk reward versus that batting average, which is really dependent on the market environment that you're in. So I hope you guys enjoy this video. Let me know your thoughts down below. If you enjoyed it, go ahead and leave a like down below and subscribe if you're new to the channel. I'll see you guys in future videos.